What is good, everybody? Welcome to an epic My Damn Toys video. This shit is not for kids. Today we have another WWE action figure set up for you guys, and this time it is unrated edition. Alright guys, so it is time for another WWE action figure setup for you guys, and I figured, you know, we got away from the element of Halloween. I wanted to do another horror setup. I'll probably do that next week or something because I really enjoy those. Those are really fun and you guys seem to enjoy those, so we'll probably go back to a horror setup next time, but this time I wanted to get a little fantasy. I wanted to get a little rated R, a little unrated, a little, you know what I'm saying, get some, bend the envelope, twist the envelope a little bit here. And so today we are diving in. We even got some Marvel characters in the house. You guys can see my man Iron Man right here. Great Marvel character of all time. My personal favorite. I am also a huge Punisher and Wolverine fan, as you guys can peep Wolverine in the back. We'll get into that in a minute. But I added some Marvel characters to the selection. We also have a couple DCs. Actually, we have one DC. But you know, we're pushing the envelope here today, and we're going to get into it, guys. We filled up the backstage arena like we always do, and we're going to take you guys through it here on this Saturday. And let's just shut the hell up and get into it, shall we? So starting off over here, guys, you will see Superman, right? I got this Superman figure. I originally actually bought this Superman because I was going to make a Superman John Cena custom, and so I purchased this. I thought that it would work. It's way too skinny, man. It's way too skinny. It's way too small. It did not work out the way I thought it would, but anyways, let's just shut the hell up, Trey. Get into the facts. So the facts are, I guess that those are facts, but the facts of this setup, guys, is that Superman has hit Triple H with an uppercut so damn hard that his head has flown off. It is literally flown off, and you guys can see there, it is no longer there. We got some blood leaking down off the neck there. You know, we gotta add the blood. The blood has to be a part of the setup. As much as we can, we gotta add to it. It makes the setup better. It makes it in depth, you know? So there he is, getting his head punched off. You know, it's gone. It's nowhere to be found. It's not even on the seal. I don't know where the hell it's got. It's gone. But there's Superman. This is not your typical Superman. It's unrated Superman. No lives are saved today, Brad. Over here, guys, you will see Black Panther. Black Panther is on the back of Braun Strowman. I really like this. That Marvel Legends Black Panther figure is so good that the joints and everything, look at how it just grips the back of Braun Strowman, just clawing the hell out of him. I love the way that looks. Like, look at Braun Strowman's face, just classic Braun Strowman yelling there. You know, we have to put Braun Strowman in there a lot because he yells. You know, his facial expression is yelling, and so I want to put it in the setup as much as possible. Really gives you a lot of abilities there with the setup, way to be creative. So I have Black Panther just sort of clawing his back there. Again, all the superheroes in today's setup are not really saving the day. They're more of, I should call it villain edition, I guess, or something, but we're going with unrated. So there's Braun Strowman and Black Panther. And we go to the middle, guys. You guys saw this at the beginning. We got Iron Man hitting a pulse blast through the stomach slash chest area of Seth Rollins. You can see him just screaming in agony right there. You guys probably remember this Seth Rollins from the Big Daddy Biggest Horror setup ever. And we'll probably put this in a lot of them. I'll probably make another figure or something because I don't want to use Seth every single time. But I figured add this one because, you know, unrated. His stomach is blown the hell open, for Christ's sake. You guys can see here, Iron Man has pulse blasted through his stomach. Seth Rollins yelling right there, and Iron Man getting the best of Seth Rollins. To tie into this portion of the setup, I actually have somebody coming to save the day, and I figured this would be cool because you guys know that this Mustafa Ali Elite, it has the pulse blasting, like Iron Man style pulse blasters on the hands or the gloves, and so I wanted to have, you know, Ali's a good dude. You know, Iron Man's typically a good dude. Tony Stark's usually a good guy, but in the setup, he's not, and Mustafa Ali is the light, and he's trying to come to save Rollins, but you guys can clearly see a little bit too late there, Brad. He is absolutely getting destroyed there with the pulse blast through the stomach, and I thought that was a pretty cool shot there. So Iron Man has definitely destroyed him, and you know, I guess we're going to have a little face-off with Mustafa Ali and Iron Man. I don't remember what setup it was. Remember, we had Mustafa Ali and Iron Man. Mustafa Ali was pulse blasting Trash Corbin out of the wheelchair in that one setup. So I guess Iron Man came back, and he's like, where the hell is that house? So maybe they'll fight it up. Who knows? Coming over here, guys, we have one of the memes of the channel. You have gunshot victim AJ Styles, and he's making a reappearance here with Roddy Piper putting a gun to the skull. You know, that's definitely unrated right there. Just look at him. He's crazed. He's yelling in his face. Could probably make like a Joker custom or something out of that head scan of Roddy Piper. Just putting the gun to the barrel to the dome of AJ Styles. So we have the meme AJ Styles returning to the setup. So I wanted to include him. I had to include him. You can see the blood leaking down right here. You guys can see the blood there. And Roddy Piper's just going insane. Always appreciated Roddy Piper's work. Just an excellent talent. One of the best promos of all time. If we go just beyond that, guys, you will see we have Kurt Angle running for his life. You guys know, just like Braun Strowman, right? Just like Braun Strowman, this head sculpt is perfect for screaming and yelling and getting away. So that's what he's doing, right? You think he's getting away. He's like, oh, hell nah, Brad. But, you know, he's looking there. And if you zoom in the back, what do you see? You see in the distance, Undertaker has an AR and he's got the scope on there. It would not put the eye over the scope. I really wanted to put the eye over the scope, but you can see in the distance there, he's got that AR. He's got his scope. You can see the grin on his face, holding the breath, you know, hold for 3 seconds, tink, 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 and you know, yeah, Kurt Angle's going down, Brad. He's going down, and so he's running away. Unrated version here in the setup. So Kurt Angle's running away from Undertaker. Look at the distance there. That's a good shot right there. You can capture them both. Perfectly captured, and Kurt Angle and Undertaker in the setup. If we go right here, guys, we have my created wrestler slash Michael Myers slash evil guy right here. I figured this would be pretty unrated because, you know, Seth Rollins, this is the naked Seth Rollins, but he's, you know, he doesn't have legs. If you guys can see that, his legs are off right now. I don't know if you guys can see that. I'm trying my best to get around, but his legs are off, and Seth Rollins is in the wheelchair because his legs are off, because you guys know, like, Lieutenant Dan from Forrest Gump, you know, trying to get the hell away, and it's not very nice of Michael Myers or whoever this guy is under the mask to go after, you know, somebody that's in a wheelchair, let alone, you know, doesn't have legs, and he's attacking them. You know, that's pretty unrated. That's pretty X-rated. Like, that's pretty inappropriate. So he's going after him there, so I figured I could add that to the setup, sort of like a horror film type deal. I don't have any of my horror figures. That's why you don't see any horror figures. I wanted to exclusively put that in the horror setup that we'll probably have next week. So I wanted to save on that one. But there's Rollins, and this is a little bit of horror that you'll get in this video. Is Michael Myers slash create a wrestler slash whatever the hell we name him is right here. If we come to the left, guys, into the middle of the setup, you will see here. I don't know if you guys remember the rated R edition of the WWE action figure setup, but I used this tub as a hot tub, and I had Pennywise in the hot tub with Candice Michelle, and I think that's supposed to be Tori Wilson there inside the hot tub, and so I just sort of put Elias there. I thought, you know, use the new Elite 73 Elias. I thought, you know, he's looking jacked. He's looking good with his khaki pants. He's ruining the khaki pants by putting them in the water. I didn't fill it up with water this time because you guys know last time it flooded the backstage and it was a big mess, and I tried to go the extra mile, but it started leaking, and I didn't want to leak the backstage today, so I definitely left that out of the setup. But just imagine there's water there. I mean, come on, use the imagination, Brad. YouTube trying to kill the imagination of the children. It's there. But this shit ain't for kids, right? So Elias is here in the hot tub with the ladies. If we go just beyond, guys, you will see Hulk Hogan. He was in the thumbnail, I do believe. And I love this shot. I love this shot because it's, like, so American, right? You got your AK. That figure, that Storm Collectibles Hulk Hogan is perfect for posing. And it fits that AK-47 that we bought. It's bigger. It's too big for Mattel figures, in my personal opinion. But I think it fits perfectly with the Storm Collectibles. And he holds it perfectly. I just love that. I know the stock isn't supposed to be off the arm like that, but I think that's just so brilliant how that looks. It's just so American, man. Hulk Hogan, and then, you know, you have the AK, and he's just, even the necklace going off to the side, it kind of looks like he's firing it, so it's even better. So that, I just love that part right there. He's yelling, he's like, ah, and you T-T-T-T-T-T-T. That's just wonderful. So you have Hulk Hogan there, and not only do we have Hulk Hogan there, but you have, Yeah. We have a poor victim over here on the table. And we even got the blood puddle right there. Just taking him out. Hulk Hogan with the AK. I just love that, man. I need to add gunshot effects. You guys already saw this part of the setup, but it is Undertaker on top of the storage unit with the AR. Just taking out Kurt Angle right there. Coming just beyond, we do have Wolverine, guys. And Wolverine has taken out my boy Ziggler. Ziggler has had his arms cut off by Wolverine, and he's on top of him there, you know, just yelling. Wolverine's claws are out. You know, he went right at Ziggler. Ziggler yelling. I know that Ziggler face is more of a scream, like, you know, kind of like an excited, like, yeah, but no, Brad, it's gonna be a no for me, dog. Today, it's a no, and Ziggler has his arms chopped off by Wolverine. If we come to the left part of the setup, before we get over there, screw it, we're gonna go over here. I don't know if you guys can see who's driving the car, but it is John Cena. I used that brand new, beautiful fix-up from Action Figure Surgery, episode 37. If you guys missed Action Figure Surgery, episode 37, definitely check it out. Let me see if I can go over the top. Can I get it? Can I get it? Yeah, there he is right there. Beautiful looking fix up, and he's driving the car. And, you know, it's got to be unrated because he ran over Lars Sullivan. And Lars Sullivan's already injured. That's what the stretcher is supposed to represent. You know, he's already injured. And, yeah, John Cena just ran him over because, you know, I can't stand Lars Sullivan. I don't want him to be injured. I don't want him to get run over. But I figured it needed to be a wrestler I'm not typically fond of, so I went with Lars Sullivan, man. Just Lars Sullivan, so boring, just comes out the crickets, just get him out, but John Cena taking him out for me there. So there's John Cena and Lars Sullivan, and then finishing off our setup, guys, you will see Tyson Kidd over here on the stretcher slash hospital bed, whatever you want to call it, and Tyson Kidd is handcuffed behind his back, bag over the skull, so he doesn't know what the hell's coming, but if you go up the structure here on the left side, you will see Jeffrey Hardy coming down off of the stretcher, you jackass, off of the scaffolding, if you will. Jeff Hardy coming off the scaffolding on to Tyson Kidd and about to just plant him there. Can you imagine if it's just pitch black and, you know, you're just sitting there waiting something, you can't move, you're restrained to a table, and then all of a sudden your sternum, your stomach, your chest, your everything just caves the hell in, can't breathe, just gets destroyed by a swanton bomb. Can you imagine, Brad? It would definitely be devastating. But I think that is our full unrated WWE action figure setup. I tried to think outside the box on this one. I wanted to do a setup for today, and I wanted to do it outside of the box. So I tried to think of some pretty cool things. I think my favorite portion of it, I don't know. I really don't know what my favorite portion is. Probably just this capture right here. How well this AK fits in the hand of Hulk Hogan and the way he's yelling and it fits the facial expression like he's angry shooting the weapon. I love that. Or I like the Iron Man Pulse Blast. That's got to be my favorite. Either the Iron Man or the Hulk Hogan. They'll probably go in the thumbnail because of how much I love them. Just the way they look. But I want to know down in the comment section below, guys, which one is your favorite? You like the Iron Man? You like the freaking Michael Myers? Let me know down in the comment section below. That is going to do it for today's setup video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Comment down below your favorite portion. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE action figure videos. Subscribe, and I just said that. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you. Ah!